السلام عليكم. Thanks a lot for the organizing committee for inviting me for this session. Thanks for the chairpersons. Thanks for the attendee for setting the third day in the weekend. And I think the minister is supposed to do twice for the attendee action next time. Today the talk is about the updates of hematology. The outlines will be Hodgkin, lymphoma early and local advanced, and non-Hodgkin also early and local advanced, and low grade, and some with the third techniques. I hope I could finish all the slides, helping me please. This is actually, I need to thank also all my mentors during my residence and during my practice, and Prof. Zaki and Prof. Ashraf Farag and Prof. Dr. Yusuf Bayoun. Actually, they give me a lot of experience. First question I'll introduce for the colleagues here. I think resident traditional oncology can answer this one easily. Mention three hematological malignancies can be cured by radiotherapy alone. So the first one, we know that non-classic Hodgkin lymphoma, non-classic Hodgkin lymphoma, nodular lymphocytic predominant stage 1 and 2A can be cured by radiotherapy, 30 grade to 36. The second is low-grade non-Hodgkin lymphoma, early stages also, stage 1 and 2, as a curative intent, but please do bone marrow staging and PET-CT in addition before treatment, and you can treat by 24 grade over 12 fractions. And solitary plasmacytoma after plasma and myeloma panel work up with close monitoring after treatment because some of these patients relapse after. And for sure, the if you will treat by radiotherapy alone, you're supposed to do like the involvocyte radiotherapy 1.5 centimeter plus some adjacent lymph. We will start by some cases interactive. We will try to be interactive discussion about these cases. One of the challenging cases came to me actually. This is one medical student. He was having initial stage 2, 3 groups of lymphoma, bilateral neck and mediastinal, not bulky. Biopsy showed classic Hodgkin lymphoma, ESR was normal. He was having, like, unfortunately, azoospermia before in the panel of workup for chemotherapy. So, what are the treatment or best treatment option for this patient? Just please raise your hand if you agree for the first option, 2 cycles ABVD plus involved site radiotherapy 20 gray over 10 fractions. Who agreed for this one? No one agreed? You agreed for this first option? Actually, I disagree for this one because in the German Hodgkin lymphoma group, they included only the 2 sites of lymphoma. So this patient had 3 sites of lymphoma, bilateral neck plus mediastinal. So I disagree with this one. Second option, 4 cycles ABVD FPET after 2 cycles negative. Who agreed for this one? Yes, agree for this one. You can give chemotherapy alone for those early patients. As you are the URTC study, third option is 3 cycles ABVD and FPET negative after 2 cycles. You will observe. Who will agree for this one? I disagree with this one actually because actually it is removed from that. Just 2 months back, we were giving for the residents through the program, but this one is one of the options, but unfortunately, they removed it from the NCCN guidelines. Because the progression-free survival for those patients receiving 3 cycles chemotherapy is less than in the arm of no radiotherapy than the arm of radiotherapy. So this one, I disagree. These 3 cycles plus radiotherapy, it can be an option. For ABVD, then for ABVD, this is as per Russell protocol, and I agree for this one. So actually, we have 3 options for this patient. Either 4 cycles ABVD, only chemo, or 3 cycles plus radiotherapy combined modality, or systemic treatment, but 2 ABVD plus 4 ABVD. And for sure, we will do PET-CT after 2 cycles to assess the response. And we will remove, again, the external beam radiotherapy because we know that only the 3 hematological, or there are other continuous, but the one of the, we cannot do it by radiotherapy alone, the Hodgkin classic need combined modality. So this is the guidelines that are recent, and we're supposed to be updated daily for the NCCN actually. They removed the option of the chemotherapy alone, the three cycles because the progression free survival is less. And here, the option of the German Hodgkin will be excluded also because this is the three cycles. But please, you're supposed to know when the inclusion criteria of German Hodgkin is one or two sites of lymph node. And the, actually, it is good achievement doing the gray and two cycles ABVD. And the 10 year survival is about 94%, and progression free survival 87%. But please remember the German Hodgkin is 5 group only in superdiaphragmatic, and for the Ann Arbor it is 9. So review the inclusion factor of the study, and they review also the sites. For example, here the bilateral neck, if the patient has neck and superclav, you will find that Ann Arbor is 2 group, but in German Hodgkin is 1 group only. And for sure, the risk factors for those patients is different. In the German Hodgkin, they're putting it out different a little bit, and the number of nodal sites. For this patient, actually, he was treated by 2 cycles. The primary hematologist preferred to do 2 cycles, and they said that as per NCCN, it is low risk, but I prefer to give him 30 gray, actually, not 20 gray, because it is not fulfilling all the criteria of the German Hodgkin. For this one, the rapid UK, this is recent. This is the one that had a little bit the omission for the survey. They are trying to do de-escalation of the radio survey all over time and escalation. This one, after PET, 3 cycles, if they found Dovili 1 and 2 on it, and they were so strict in the Dovili criteria for this study, and they did randomization, no further treatment versus further radiosurgery 30 grade. We found as per intention to treat, the patient just randomized to radiosurgery or no, the progression free survival was equal or comparable. And not significant. This is a bit high in the survey arm, but not significant. But as per protocol, as per the survey arm, they in favor of the survey and about 7% and significant. And I think for this one, they removed it from the EU. So please, if you wish to walk from higher distance, either to use four legs and 2 ropes, or use balance stick and use good staging and good risk factors. This is a 5-point scale for the FDG Dovili, and you're supposed to read well the rapid, the study itself, the rapid, actually the strict criteria for the Dovili 1 and 2 only are negative, and for the other studies, mostly they consider 1 and 2 and 3. This is the second scenario in our Hodgkin lymphoma journey. 30-year Filipino, she presented with bulky mediastinal, and she was treated in a private system by 8 cycles. And this is unusual, actually, and extra dose for the chemo. And reviewed all the images, like our seniors are doing or are training us. You're supposed to check the initial one after 2 cycles after end of the treatment. And we reviewed, we found the bulk mediastinal for the initial, more than third of the thoracic diameter. And after 2 cycles, mashallah, good, excellent response to really 2 the mediastinal. And after the 6, the mass is still there, but to really negative. It's about 5.4 by 1.8. Something. But what do you say? Should we give radiosurgery or no for this scenario? You will agree, even after 8 cycles ABVD, you know, each cycle of ABVD is giving about 5 gray for the heart. And we are trying to decrease 1 gray for the cardiac toxicity, and they are giving 8 cycles. The heart has received about 40 gray of radiosurgery. Without giving you this, still we did peer review with Dr. Babir, Dr. Bayoum, and me, actually, and we decided for this patient to say it's cycle for toxicity, and she achieved the really 2 after the end, and after the instead persistent negative after the end. So we didn't give the patient to deserve, and also as per Russell protocol. They didn't do proper randomization of the RSL study, but still they put the patients that achieving 2 after really after 2 cycles negative, they put the patient on no radiotherapy, and the results are. So this patient actually in the follow-up in September and on March, it is negative, and even the size of mass is decreasing without radiotherapy. For sure, it may happen, the recurrence, but at least we are going for the guidelines and updated, and we are trying to adjusting the treatment for the patient. Please try to adjust for focal patients, don't give extra or under focal. And this is the updated of the guidelines in January 2024. They put January even before January come, but they really serve for stage three and four. You can omit, or even stage one and two unfavorable, you can omit the radio survey for those patients that are achieving CR. And for the local advanced, still they are putting in the arm that negative by Duvili after two cycles and after the end of the treatment, you can consider this. Like you mentioned, Dr., but still those patients, you're supposed to adjust it according to the toxicity and acute risk factors. So in conclusion, this was a study they did after two cycles, one to three, outcome if they omitted the bleomycin, and they said no indication for radiotherapy, even for bulky disease. And they, for sure, after two cycles, they did escalation for Beco. And here you can give radiotherapy for those not responding after two cycles. We are still in our center doing case by case according to the, and this is the case we consider a mission for the therapy for the 8 cycles and because the patient achieved, but some patients with residual, but we can do with the survey as per the guidelines state, they are doing the optional for this. But we have two prospective study, and it is updated in the UK guidelines, Italian studies, they put no reserve versus radio survey, and they said that for the early state, for the bulky Hodgkin lymphoma, they said still radio survey didn't add more progression for survival. Last scenario in our project informer, 69-year-old, stage 4. She was a little bit frail, PS 1 or 2. She achieved good, excellent response after 2 cycles of MVD, and they omitted the bleomycin. And after 6 cycles, unfortunately, the pet was, and Duvili was 2 after 2 cycles, and after the end, Duvili was 4 for the inguinal femoral lymphoma. And this is one of the important reasons to do staging workup. Complete, even if after 2 cycles negative, we suppose after the end, we do supposed to do another staging. This patient referred for further management. Who will agree for the survey that do really fall? Or you will refer the patient for transplant for this and the biopsy? With the survey or no? With the survey, can you raise your hand? With the survey, no? Actually, she is frail. The hematologist actually is encouraging or like forces us to give radiotherapy. Even the guidelines review, you can give radiotherapy for partial responding between the really 4 or 5 higher dose, 36 to 45. We give up to 42 for this patient. Fortunately, the local treatment was excellent and achieved CR, but unfortunately, she, after 3 months assessment, and those patients were supposed to be meticulous in the follow-up after the 3 months, and she had distant relapse. And another biopsy from the lesion, it appears a sensitive variant of Hodgkin, and it is so aggressive. You can do altered fractionation. I know Dr. Nadim will not be happy. He's not here. It's okay. So in lymphoma, in era of COVID area, we did some hyperfractionation. Sometimes third patient or elderly can do this according to International Lymphoma Relation College group, and I am recommending this site actually. The relapse disease for sure, second line and transplant. You can do the therapy if the patient didn't achieve CR either before or after, and we do in the Hodgkin. Non-classic Hodgkin lymphoma stage 1 and 2A, we're supposed to force for radio survey alone because this is the ASPO guidelines and this is the excellent outcome. Just to we'll move quick for the non-Hodgkin update. I'll start by history because history is very important. This is a map of Egypt, and we know from history of thousands of years that we have a problem in the northeast, actually, side. But we are, all the enemies actually came from this side, so we put 50% of our army here in this area just to attack this one. So working formulation, I'm encouraging all the newer generation to hit this one again. The low grade intermediate. This is clinical actually grading for the lymphoma. Low grade is motile innocent cells, and actually this is follicular or low grade lymphoma. Intermediate and high we can treat as aggressive. And why we change it again to 20 WHO, because there is from the immunosuppressant and the B cell and T cell and also the mantle and the so aggressive. So, and again, we change it to double hit and triple hit. And we're supposed to talk the same language like hematologist, and we're supposed to know the immunosuppressant. Because there are some studies about double hit and triple hit to increase the dose of radiotherapy. In diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, we're supposed to know the recognition. And first scenario for the non-Hodgkin lymphoma, one patient, less than 60 years, ES0, IPI0, biopsy from left tonsil. He had left tonsil, and by the way, the tonsil is still nodal. So stage one, tonsil, diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. How would you treat? First option, six cycles are short. Who will agree for this one? No one, no one hematologist. So it's okay, one of the options can be six cycles, our shop. 40 degree over 20 with the survey alone. We agreed there is no with the survey apart from the previous series now. So no with the survey alone for the first time. It's aggressive. So need system, need combined modality. Three, four cycles, our shop plus 30 degree. We can do this one, yes, agree. Six cycles, our shop plus 30. This is too much. Four cycles, our shop plus two rituximab alone. We can do this one. This is because the study fell out. This is actually, I think, in for 2020 was there as time. Okay, so in the for 2020, there was there the four study for cycles upshot plus two cycles rituximab as per fell out. But again, in the new one, they didn't mention in the new one, they removed this one, but still in the manuscript, the flyer study that four cycles of option plus two rituximab alone, and it is comparing between the actually six cycles of option. This is not good randomization. We're supposed to put the three cycles of option plus rituximab in the arm. Most of the studies actually came from the hematologist. We need from Mr. also to do some studies regarding the radiation oncology. And we can put the good randomization between all three arms. But in this arm, in this study, they said that four cycles of option plus two rituximab can be as an option for the IPI zero. And the PS zero also, and less than 60 years, and one. We know swap study, I'll not take too much for this one, but the updated from the swap, but this one is important, the stage one to IPI, sometimes the IPI is high, you can even agree for the hematologist to give more chemotherapy rather than giving combined treatment. And for skeletal and the initial bulk, you're supposed to give chemotherapy as per two studies, recover and end. And I go for this one, study recover and dement in initial bulky, and I think Victoria will be so happy by this one. And there is another one, unfolder. It's 20% difference in the arm that receiving radiosurgery for initial bulky and the extranodal site. So better to give for initial bulky and the extranodal sites radiosurgery, and they are giving 20% difference in it. The extranodal sites with non-Hodgkin, you're supposed to take care of it a bit and give more chemo six cycle recommendation and give, so you can give it as well. Particular non-Hodgkin, you can give for the contralateral and the 30 gray and also for intersecret, don't forget the CNS and don't forget the sperm bank for those patients. For primary mediastinal non-Hodgkin, we know we suppose again to talk the same language like the hematologist. If the patient receive dose adjusted, I don't know exactly the dose adjusted. I asked the hematologist, he told me that dose adjusted, this is the name, but they are giving escalating and according to tolerance of the patient they are giving. If the patient receive full regimen, we can omit the reserve even if it's initial bulk because the results of this protocol is higher. So if the patient primary mediastinal lymphoma and they receive dose adjusted, for the regimen, you can meet with yourself. Otherwise, if you see the outshock, we're supposed to give with yourself. And most of the people, high access to the patient females, and we're supposed to decrease the rate of this. The CNS lymphoma for sure, if not fit for systemic treatment, we can give the alternative to whole brain therapy. And for the dose, we are giving 30 grade, can it will increase to 36. But we know the UK study that did comparison between 30 and 34, and they found disease control was the same. But all actual group of non-Hodgkin people, they didn't specify for certain sites, but we are giving for the external nodal higher a little bit than the nodal, and we are giving 36 sometimes if still residual disease. This is a summary for the, and for the follow-up, for the, those patients, Hodgkin and non-Hodgkin, we can limit a little bit the radiology, we can do clinical examination history, and also some lab can help us, and we can do image, but this frequently than the others patients. For follicular lymphoma, just we know that the 24 over 12 is equal 30 gray, more or less equal. This is a standard of 24 gray. But I need to give more attention for the follow-up study for 4 gray in 2 fractions. This is the lowest dose I know for the all treatment we can get 4 or 2 only, and it achieves good local control. And we can, but in progression-free survival, not in overall survival. And please try to use some medication for tumor lysis for those patients. Because we are giving the survey alone, but still those can be in frail patient or elderly patient, because this dose actually the overall survival is higher for the 24. They are trying to do some studies about those patients in mild lymphoma, 4 and 2. This is abstract only in ASH, 4 and 2 versus 24. They are giving 4 and 2 and wait 3 to 4 months. If the patient achieve CR, they are excluded, and that's it for them. If the patient still have disease, they are continuing with it. And this is Poseidon Adebejo, one of the famous MD Anderson Radiation Oncology, and this is one of the ILROG group, and I am recommending to follow her because she's... This is in Daranapsid, and if you will do transplant, and this is also famous paper from ILROG for the transplantable patient non-Hodgkin, and they're giving 6 scenarios, just the timing for the radiotherapy before transplant, and they are giving more indications than that we are practicing sometimes, even bulky with relapsing disease, older 5 centimeters is the indication of radiotherapy before transplant, and we can, the timing actually within 1 month before or within 4 weeks to 12 weeks after, and the doses are there. Lastly, the volumes and techniques. Quickly, this is the mediastinal in Hodgkin lymphoma, the butterfly technique. The breast dose is less, and the organ at risk is this. This is the butterfly. We met 2 half-arc anterior and 2 half-arc posterior. We did it in our center, and we did it even for non-hematological in some phlegoma cases, and even spinal cases. We raised the patient 15 degrees with back look and just chin mask, because we don't have the facility of the whole mask with the breast board. And actually, it's achieved good results for the breast dose and for the heart dose. Remember that the this is the volumes you're supposed to read it in the ILRG, and you're supposed to do this for not for the CT for patients to displace the heart and decrease the dose, and also for the upper abdominal organs. Finally, the doses you're supposed to put the spleen dose for sure. All the organs is important, and it's supposed to be less than the solid tumors, and spleen is supposed to be less than 10 gray. In conclusion, because you will give me, I think. Careful decision is important. Multidisciplinary team for all patients. Regular follow-up. Breast screening after 8 years for the patient receiving radiotherapy for the mediastinal. Careful observation is very important. New modality is supposed to be used. And CT simulation you can use for with IP contrast and in 2 positions just to compare. Organ at risk is this. Technique, final review, all the updates regarding before treatment, and for the mister waiting for the multiple perspective, multiple centers perspective study. Thank you a lot for your attention.